God. Oh, that's what God, said, that's what I've been trying to show you in your life. I've been trying to bring you to a place where you realize I'm trying to teach you in this place that you're at. I'm trying to teach you. Oh, praise God. You know why God left him there for 40 years? He had to kill out all the rebels. He had to kill out all the rebels. Amen. Every rebel. Amen. If I can just apply it to us, he had to kill out every ounce of flesh that was going to rebel against the law of God. Amen. Every self-righteous. Amen. Ounce of my flesh that was going to rise up. Amen. He's trying to kill it. He's trying to let it die here in the wilderness. Oh, praise God. And then I was just listening and hearing about, amen, about what Sister Christian was preaching, how she began to share, amen, about seeing the edge of that wilderness. Amen. Seeing the edge of that wilderness. Oh, my Lord. Amen. Oh, God, will begin to show me once you begin to learn what I'm trying to teach you in the wilderness, you'll begin to see the edge and you'll begin to look over into what Canaan is all about. Oh, praise God. You begin to see it. It's not a way that you passed before. It's not something you're familiar with, but you'll begin to get a glimpse of where I've been trying to get you the whole time. Oh, praise God. I've been trying to teach you. Oh, I've been trying to bring you to a place where you can learn to walk with me, a place where you don't depend on anybody else, where you don't depend on this present life, but you depend on me. Oh, praise God, where you're not a man living in time, but you're living with your head, which is Christ, in eternity, not judged and ruled and governed by time, space, or matter, but governed by all eternity, where there's no limits, where there's no bounds, where there's all the divine resources of God. I've been trying to show you. I've been trying to show you. And Ephesians 4 tells us, we got to put off that old man. We got to put off our previous manner of life. That's what he was doing in the wilderness. He was putting off that old man. He's putting out that Egypt mentality. Because you see, if we're not careful, amen, I'm just being open with you this morning. I'm being transparent about my life. Amen, about what God is teaching me, what he's been teaching me, what he spoke to me last night, made it more real to me this morning in the prayer. Amen, he said, I've been, oh, praise God, so many times you've had that that Egypt mentality, amen, of saying, oh, praise God, I know that I was bound back there where I was at. I know that I was limited. Oh, praise God, but at least that wasn't the wilderness. At least that wasn't this place that is so dry. At least it wasn't this place where all I can do is live in a tent and I'm carried from one place to the next. Oh, my Lord, amen. God began to show me, amen, oh, how that, and I beg God for mercy and forgiveness. Let that old conversation, let that old mind, let that old thinking be put off. Let it be put down. Let it be put down. But as soon as the last rebel dies, as soon as that last rebel dies, we'll go into Canaan. As soon as that last part of your flesh and my flesh dies, you'll enter into that place that God, oh, that place, you know what that place is? It's a place of rest. That's what Jesus was talking about. It's a place of rest. It's a place where God's kingdom can be realized and brought to reality. Oh, praise God, and brought to its fullness. Amen. As soon as that last rebel dies, oh, praise God. And then I begin to pray, and God said, do you know who that last rebel was? It was Moses. As powerful as a man that Moses was, as meek and, oh, praise God, as much of a man of God that he was, he brought the law of God. Amen. He came down from a mountain with the glory of God still shining on his face. He was still a rebel. What was his rebellion? It was the pride of his own ministry. The pride of his own ministry. He disobeyed God. He came, God said, speak to the rock. He took his rod. He said, this is what I'm going to do. I've done it before. I'll do it again. He smote that rock and the water came out. He had a pride in his own ministry. But as soon as the pride of ministry died, you know what happened? The ministry of Christ came up. the ministry of Jesus. Amen. I know as you've studied in the school of Christ, amen, we know, amen, that Joshua in the Hebrew is the same as Jesus in the Greek. So as soon as Moses died, as soon as the pride of ministry died, amen, oh, praise God, I'm talking about more than preaching. I'm talking about the ministry of your life. You come, and the only reason you're praying is because you're getting ready to do something, amen, in the service, or do something for the church. Amen. You got a pride in your ministry. Amen. All praise God. If the only reason that I was praying last night and the only reason that I was seeking God this morning is because I was going to stand in this pulpit, amen, after a little while, that's a pride in my own ministry, and I'll never be able to enter into that land of Canaan until that last rebel dies. Until that last man who said, I'm going to do it my own way. That old man, until he comes to death. But once he dies, it's not going to be my ministry, but it's going to be the ministry of Christ. Where they're going to say, well, Jesus is doing this. Oh, I thought preacher so-and-so or brother so-and-so or sister so-and-so was doing it. Amen. But it gets to the place where we're going in that yoke with Jesus Christ. Amen. He is the one who is leading us. Amen. He's the one who's doing it. Amen. But he's doing it through us. He's using us as his vessel. Praise God. He's showing me as soon as the pride in your ministry dies, well, you're not working for the church. You're not working for a man. You're not working for the pulpit. But oh, as Ezekiel began to prophesy about the sons of Zadok, they shall be ministers unto me. They shall be ministers unto me. So this morning, praise God, this morning, that's what God was speaking to me. And I pray that God has spoken to your hearts. Amen. You know, it's not about the sower. It's not about the one who throws out the seeds. The word of God never changes. It's always the same. Amen. But you know what God really wants to do? He wants to look at your ground. He wants to look at your soil. Amen. And say, are you the ground by the wayside? Amen. Are you the ground that the seed goes on but it can't penetrate down into? Are you the seed that's so shallow that it springs up but it doesn't have a root that it's going to live? Are you that one, amen, that the seed may go into but it gets choked out? Or are you a part of that 25% of ground, amen, that the seed goes down deep and produces fruit? Stand with me this morning. Praise God. Hallelujah.